So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also follow me here. Here also you can ask anything related to examinations. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statement with respect to the Indian footwear and leather development program, and you have to identify the correct statement. But first of all, the question is that a new program? Is that a newly launched program? No, it is not. It is a news because the Union Cabinet has approved the continuation of this program, and that's why here is the question. Alright, so let's talk about the news then. What is the news? The Union Cabinet has approved the continuation, the extension of Indian Footwear and Leather Development Program till 31st March 2026 or till further review, whichever is earlier. ये थोड़ी सी नई बात इस बार आई है, कोई fixed date दी है इन्होंने, but साथ में ये लिख दिया है, it will be continued till further review or 31st March 2026, whichever is earlier. अगर 31st March 2026 से पहले रिव्यू कर लिया गया और उस टाइम डिसाइड किया गया कि लेट्स डिसकंटिन्यू दिस स्कीम, देन इट विल बी डिसकंटिन्यूड. ऑलराइट, एंड सो रिमेंबर दिस डेट 31st March 2026, बेसिकली टिल द एंड ऑफ दिस फाइनेंस कमीशन. ऑलराइट, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम, सो रिमेंबर देर आर वेरी बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम. सी, अगर कोई इस तरीके की चीज न्यूज में होती है, सो प्लीज जस्ट डोंट गो थ्रू कि हाँ इसको कंटिन्यू कर दिया गया है टिल 31st मार्च. उसके बारे में थोड़ा सा जानना जरूरी है. ऑलराइट, और वो काम मैं आपके लिए कर रहा हूँ. सो ऑब्जेक्टिव, व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम? नंबर वन इज टू डेवलप द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर द लेदर सेक्टर. ठीक है, पहला क्या है? टू डेवलप इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर द लेदर सेक्टर. नंबर टू, टू एड्रेस द एनवायरमेंटल कंसर्न्स स्पेसिफिक टू लेदर सेक्टर. लेदर सेक्टर के रिलेटेड जो भी एनवायरमेंटल कंसर्न्स है उसको खत्म करना, उसको एड्रेस करना. एंड नंबर थ्री इज वेरी जेनरिक, to facilitate the additional investment, employment generation and increase in production in the leather sector. So these are the three broad objectives of this particular program, Indian Footwear and Leather Development Program. Remember, it was launched in the year 2017 and its first phase was from 2017 to 2021. 2017 se 21 tak ka iska phase 1 tha, and it is being implemented by Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Do remember this, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, who is also the Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Alright, so there were 7 sub-schemes in the first phase of the scheme, and in the second phase, jo ab ye launch hua hai, there are 6 sub-schemes, and the total outlay is rupees 1700 crores. Theek hai, 1700 crore ka total outlay hai, and there are 6 sub-schemes under this extended program. And which are these 6 sub-schemes? Now please don't go into the details of these sub-schemes, just the names are enough. नाम काफी है और इनका जो respective outlay है, that is also, that is enough. उससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की there is no need. So what are these 6 sub schemes? Number one is sustainable technology and environmental promotion, 500 crores. Integrated development of leather sector, 500 crore again. Establishment of institutional facilities, 200 crores. Mega leather footwear and accessories cluster development, 300 crores. Brand promotion of Indian brands in leather sector, for that 100 crores will be provided, and development of design studios ke liye bhi 100 crore rupaye diye jayenge, and in total it becomes 1700 crores. Alright, so now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the correct statement. The program has been continued up to 31st March 2025. It's not 2025, it's 2026, which means the statement is incorrect. Total outlay of extended program is 2500 crore. Is that so? No, it's 1700 crore. And it was launched in 2015. No, it was not 2015. It was 2017 when it was launched. So all the statements are incorrect here, which means option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. Alright, so I hope guys this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Rashtriya Yuva Sashaktikaran Karyakram, and you have to identify the इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट नाउ. ठीक है, इस क्वेश्चन में आपको इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करना है. नाउ अगेन द क्वेश्चन इज दैट अ न्यू प्रोग्राम, इज दैट अ न्यू कार्यक्रम, इज दैट अ न्यू मिशन, इज दैट अ न्यू स्कीम? नो, It is not. Again, it is in news because Union Cabinet has approved its extension, or you can say the continuation. Alright. So the Union Cabinet has approved the continuation of Rashtriya Yuva Sashaktikaran Karyakram till the financial year 2026, till the end of financial year 2026, which means the same date, 31st March 2026, which means basically for the period of this finance commission, जो ये वाला finance commission का जो period है, तब तक के लिए इसको extend कर दिया गया है, alright? So since it is in news, so we have to discuss about this. So let's talk about this particular program. So remember, the objective of this program, guys, is development and empowerment of youth across the country. हमारे देश के जो youth हैं, उनको develop करना और development हर तरीके की development, sports में development, technology में development, innovation में development, personality में development, skills में development. It is a scheme for holistic development of youths across the country. Alright. And it is basically an umbrella scheme. There were so many schemes which were working individually under the ambit of Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. So 2016 mein kya kara, un sabko combine karke iske andar rakh diya gaya tha. And it was named as Rashtriya Yuva Sashaktikaran Karyakram. Alright. It was launched in the year 2016 and लॉन्च करने के बाद ये कोई नई स्कीम नहीं थी बेसिकली द देन वेरियस स्कीम्स विच वर बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स ऑल दोस स्कीम्स वर पुट अंडर दिस अम्ब्रेला स्कीम एंड इट वाज नेम्ड एज राष्ट्रीय युवा सशक्तिकरण कार्यक्रम ऑलराइट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोर्स इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर अनुराग ठाकुर एंड हु इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग अनुराग ठाकुर लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इज हमीरपुर which of course is in Himachal Pradesh. Who are the beneficiaries of this scheme? All the youth in the age group of 15 to 29 years. 15 to 29 years of youth are all the beneficiaries. हैं. And these are the 7 sub-schemes now. पहले 8 थी, अब जो continued version है, उसमें 7 sub-schemes हैं. Just the names are enough, the details are not required. Alright? And the continued version, the extended version, the total outlay is 2710.65 crores. Alright? 2710.65 crore total outlay है जो extended version है उसका. So now let's come back to the question then. You have to identify the incorrect statement. Now यहाँ पे आपको एक confusion हो सकती है इन components में, मैं आपको बता देता हूँ. ये जो international cooperation यहाँ पे 7 sub schemes में लिखा हुआ है, तो इसमें आपको confusion हो सकती है. Then how Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sport is promoting the international cooperation. Basically this cooperation is about is for the youths only. There are various organizations in the world which are working for the youths. So establishing cooperation with those organizations is the part of this component. Alright. So please don't get confused. Now you have to identify incorrect statement. The scheme was launched in 2017. It wasn't 2016. So ye incorrect ho gaya. It has been extended up to financial year 26. बिल्कुल सही बात है. And the scheme has 8 sub schemes. 8 पहले थी, अब नहीं है, अब 7 हो गई है. So 1 and 3 are incorrect, which means option C will be the correct answer. So I hope guys this question is clear. Now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about the Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship. ठीक है, so let's talk about the question. Again, you have to consider these 3 statements about Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship and you have to identify the correct statement now. Alright, so Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship, guys, remember it was launched under the Waste to Wealth Mission. There is a mission, Waste to Wealth Mission. Or kiska mission hai? It is the mission of Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. And who is he? Professor Vijay Raghavan. So Waste to Wealth Mission ke under Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship was launched in the year 2021. Do remember this. So it is basically a fellowship program. Alright. So the very first edition of fellowship were given in the year 2021. And now the Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship 2022 has been announced. Okay, so that's why it is in news. So Swachhta Swarthi Fellowship 2022 has been announced under the Waste to Wealth Mission of the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. And talking about this fellowship, so remember the objective of this fellowship is to recognize students, whether it is school student or college student, it is to recognize community workers, is to recognize the sanitary workers. For what? who are engaged in tackling the challenges of waste management in the country. ऐसे लोग बेसिकली, ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स, ऐसे एसएचजी वर्कर्स, ऐसे कम्युनिटी वर्कर्स, ऐसे सैनिटेशन वर्कर्स हु आर एंगेज्ड इन वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट अक्रॉस द कंट्रीज. सो टू रिकॉग्नाइज देम, दिस स्वच्छता सारथी फेलोशिप वाज अनाउंस्ड इन द ईयर 2021 एंड दे आर कॉलिंग देम, दीज पीपल आर कॉल्ड एज स्वच्छता सारथीज, स्वच्छता सारथीज, और यू कैन से क्लीनलीनेस फेलोज. ऑलराइट, it was launched in the year 2021 under waste to wealth mission of PM's TIAC. What is this TIAC? Science Technology Innovation Advisory Council. All right, the 2021 cohort had 344 swachhata sarthis across 27 states and 6 UTs, and in the 2022 500 fellowships will be provided. 2022 mein kitne diye jayenge? 500. All right, and beneficiaries school students, college students, SHGs and sanitation workers. Talking about the details, अगर हम details की बात करें, so if the beneficiary is a school student of standard 9th to 12th, then 500 per month दिए जाते हैं for a period of 1 year. If the beneficiary is a UG, PG and research student, 1000 per month for a period of 1 year. If the beneficiary is a SHG or sanitary worker, 2000 per month for 1 year. All right, so please do remember this amount also, this can also be asked in your exams. Moving ahead, so you have to identify the correct statement. So it was launched in 2020 under waste to wealth mission. No, not 2020, 2021. So incorrect ho gaya. It is being implemented by the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs. So swachhata ko dekh ke hamesha housing and urban affairs pe answer mat karna. In most of the cases the answer would be Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs, but not always. This time it is being implemented by the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor. In 2022, up to 500 fellowships will be provided, जो कि बिल्कुल सही बात है. Only 3 will be the correct answer, option D. Moving ahead to question number 4. In how many districts intensified mission Indradhanush 4.0 has been launched? Very, very important question. और इससे पहले वाले जो तीनों थे, तीनों के तीनों super important question है. किसी ना किसी exam में इनमें से कोई ना कोई question definitely आने वाला है. This also, this is also very important. So intensified mission Indradhanush 4.0, the fourth edition has been launched. So before moving ahead to the fourth edition, let's talk about the mission Indradhanush. So remember, mission Indradhanush was launched in the year 2014 by the government of India through Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. ठीक है, and the objective of this mission is to achieve 100% immunization, 100% vaccination of the children up to 2 years of age and pregnant women. दो साल के बच्चों का और प्रेग्नेंट, दो साल तक के बच्चों का और प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन का 100% इम्यूनाइजेशन एंड वैक्सीनेशन वाज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ मिशन इंद्रधनुष लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2014 एंड इनिशियली इट वाज फोकस्ड ऑन 201 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स अक्रॉस 27 स्टेट्स. ठीक है, ये फैक्ट याद रखना इतना इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है. तो शुरू में जो फोकस था दैट वॉज ऑन 201 डिस्ट्रिक्ट. आफ्टर द सक्सेस ऑफ दिस मिशन इंद्रधनुष, Intensified Mission Indradhanush 1.0 was launched in the year 2017. 2017 में Intensified Mission Indradhanush launch किया गया ताकि और ज्यादा intensity से vaccination provide कराया जा सके, and इसमें क्या किया था, basically targets जो थे वो increase कर दिए थे. After the success of this, Intensified Mission Indradhanush 2.0 was launched in the year 2019, and in this, in the second edition, the focus was on those districts where vaccination coverage is 70% or below. ठीक है, यहां पे जो सेकेंड एडिशन था उसमें फोकस इसके ऊपर था, उन डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स के ऊपर जहां पे वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज 70% या उससे कम है. ऑलराइट, देन इंटेंसिफाइड मिशन इंद्रधनुष 3.0 वाज लॉन्च्ड लास्ट ईयर 2021 विद सम इंक्रीज्ड टारगेट्स, एंड नाउ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर इज आउट विद द फोर्थ एडिशन ऑफ IMI. ओके, तो अब बात कर लेते हैं क्या क्या चीजें हैं. सो दिस द फोर्थ एडिशन विल हैव 3 राउंड्स एंड विल बी कंडक्टेड इन 416 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स अक्रॉस 33 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज अक्रॉस द कंट्री. ठीक है जी, ये याद रखना, यही क्वेश्चन आएगा पेपर में, क्योंकि और इसमें कुछ डिटेल है नहीं ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट. 416 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स अक्रॉस 33 स्टेट्स. द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड बेस्ड ऑन द वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज एज पर द NFHS 5 एंड हेल्थ MIS. ठीक है, HMIS और NFHS 5 के हिसाब से जो डेटा है ये जो IMI 4.0 है, ये जो districts identify किए हैं based on this data. And remember, the first round will start from 7th Feb, second will start from 7th March, and the third will start from 4th of April 2022. This is not important. Just remember, the fourth edition has been launched. In 416 districts, it will be conducted across 33 states in 3 rounds. Alright? So therefore, the correct answer will be option B, 416. Moving ahead to question number 5. Which of the following organizations has organized FinTech Open Summit in collaboration with Amazon Web Services and Ernst & Young? Now in this particular question, we do not have to go into the details because जो ये समिट वाले क्वेश्चन होते हैं इसमें सिर्फ इतना याद रखा करो कि किसने ऑर्गेनाइज किया एंड व्हाट वाज द ऑब्जेक्टिव. सो फिनटेक ओपन एज द नेम सजेस्ट इट थ्रू दिस समिट बेसिकली इट इनवाइटेड ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स इन द एरिया ऑफ फिनटेक टू एक्सचेंज आइडियाज टू एक्सचेंज इनोवेशन. ऑलराइट एंड इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय नीति आयोग. ठीक है. ऑल्सो रिमेंबर इट वाज इनॉग्रेटेड बाय मिनिस्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी and railways Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. So option A, Niti Aayog, is the correct answer, guys. And the last question for today, question number 6, with which of the following state governments an MOU has been signed by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, which is headed by Mr. Nitin Gadkari. His Lok Sabha constituency is Nagpur, the city of oranges, for development of ropeways under newly announced National Ropeway Development Program. So if you have watched the video of Union Budget 2022-23, then you must be aware of this program, National Ropeway Development Program. Alright, ye abhi abhi announced hua hai budget mein, and under this program, the very first MOU has been signed for development of ropeways in Uttarakhand. Option B, Uttarakhand, is the correct answer, and Uttarakhand Tourism Development Corporation ke saath this MOU has been signed. Okay. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you in the next session on Friday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.